These giant Chinese meatballs are awesome. They're moist and tasty, and they even have a little surprise in the middle. Hey everyone, I'm Flo, Dude is behind the camera, and we're all about simple food, simple faith. Now, these giant Chinese meatballs are not always giant. They are usually bigger than regular meatballs. They're called lion's head meatballs because I guess it resembles the head of a lion. In Chinese, they're called xi ji tao. Having to stay at home over the last several months, it has caused me to explore more recipes that I can make at home instead of eating out at a restaurant. And this is one of them. I'm trying it for the first time today. I hope that they'll turn out well so that I will continue to make them because it is one of my favorite things to eat. I'm starting off with a thumb-sized piece of ginger. We only need 2 teaspoons for the ground pork, but I'm also slicing up just 2 thin slices that I'm going to use for later. That's going to go in the wok. In the meantime, I'm going to grate the remaining into the pork, which I have 1 pound of ground pork, and it's the regular ground pork. You want something that has more fat than usual. Like normally I would buy a lean ground pork, but because I want these meatballs to be really moist, I'm just using regular ground pork. As I was researching this recipe, it always called for at least 30% fat in the pork. So I hope that's helpful. I have 6 stalks of green onion. And I'm going to take 2 of the stalks that I'm just going to cut into 2-inch pieces, like 2-inch lengths. And we're going to set this aside for later. I'm doing it now because I find with Chinese recipes, especially, that it's really important to get all of your ingredients ready to go. Not only that, but you're already chopping green onions, so you might as well just get it all done at once. And then the remaining 4 stalks of green onion, we're just going to chop it up into, well, as little pieces as you can, because that's going to go into the meatball. I'm just going to continue to mince the green onion until it's minced and not just chopped, if that makes sense. Okay, I'm just going to put that in with the ground pork. I'm going to start stirring this. And like all Chinese recipes, they always say stir the pork in one direction. So I'm going to try to get this going. It gets a little bit easier as I keep going. And what we want to do is create fibers. Okay, I'm going to add 1 tablespoon of soy sauce. 1 tablespoon of Shaoxing wine. And Shaoxing wine is a cooking wine. You can also use sherry. We've also substituted with bourbon or whiskey, and it does a good job. 1 tablespoon of oyster sauce. And 1/2 teaspoon of ground white pepper. I'm just mixing a little bit of ingredients in at a time so that I can keep stirring. Okay, and 1 large egg. And it's supposed to be quite moist, but I'm gonna be adding some panko in a sec. Okay, 2 teaspoons of cornstarch. And 1/2 cup of panko, which is just a Japanese style breadcrumb. I don't know if you guys can see, but the strands are starting to form as you continue to stir in one direction. Okay, I'm finding that the meat mixture is still a little bit dry, so I'm going to add about 2 tablespoons of water. This is supposed to be pasty. I'm adding 2 more tablespoons because it's getting there, but it's not quite right. So altogether, 1/4 cup of water. There we go. this is what you want. Kind of loose and pasty. And then we're gonna shape this into meatballs. Now for my secret surprise that's going in the middle, I've got some salted duck eggs. And there's nothing you can do to substitute duck eggs. If you don't want to use duck eggs, or if you can't find them, you can just make the meatballs as they are. But I'm just using the yolk, and that's gonna go in the middle. Well, the eggshell is really hard. Well, there we go. I'm not going to use the whites. I'm just using the yolk because I don't know how salty the egg white is, and I don't want to take any chances. And plus, I don't really need all that liquid. All right, I am making three giant meatballs. And the reason why I'm only making three is because I think if I made them any smaller, the egg yolk would totally like overwhelm the pork. I just want to have a right proportion of yolk to meat. See if I can divide this into three equal parts. Remember, this meat is also quite pasty now, right? And I'm putting this on a pan. I've already preheated my broiler. I'm just gonna make my meatballs first because I wanna make sure that they're all equal sized. See, it's way more loose than a regular meatball that you would make. That ensures that it's going to be really moist. Okay, just gonna make a little hole, and I'm gonna drop one of the egg yolks in there.
Oh, look at those chopstick skills.
Okay, let's not use any of the white. And then we're just going to pinch it. Hopefully it's in the middle. Put that side down to make sure. So while the meatballs are cooking under the broiler, I'm going to get the braising liquid and the veggies going. So this is a Napa cabbage, and we're just gonna use half of it. It's actually a lot. I'm gonna cut it in half first, and then I'm gonna rinse the leaves under water. To cut up the Napa, we're just gonna take this core out. I'm just cutting a V. And we're not gonna need that, just like regular cabbage. And I'm gonna chop it up into, I don't know, 1-inch pieces. Okay, ta-da, how easy was that?
Super.
All right, I am gonna heat up my pot. You want a pot that is going to be able to fit the meatball in there as well, because we are going to braise it. We're only leaving it under the broiler for 10 minutes. My broiler only heats up to 450, so it might take a little bit longer than regular. Add 1 tablespoon of vegetable oil. I'll throw my ginger in there. I have this on medium heat, and we're also going to throw in the white and light green parts of the green onion. And I'm just going to stir fry this for a couple of minutes. Not even a couple of minutes, maybe about a minute or so. Putting in my Napa cabbage. Take this for a minute or so. 1.5 cups of chicken broth. And if you don't have chicken broth, you can just add water. 2 teaspoons of brown sugar. And if you don't want to add sugar, just don't add it. 1 tablespoon of dark soy sauce. 1 tablespoon of regular soy sauce or light soy sauce. 1 tablespoon of oyster sauce. 1 tablespoon of Shaoxing wine. Just give this a stir. All right, that's it. That's our braising liquid. Now I'm gonna go get the meatballs. Be right back. Kind of wish that the broiler did a better job. I'm just gonna lay them down. Wanted them to be a little bit more brown. That's okay.
Our main oven is on the fritz right now.
Yeah, so I'm using my toaster oven. Okay, we're gonna turn the heat right down to low, medium low. And then we're gonna cover this. And we're gonna let this cook for about half an hour.
Smells awesome.
I know. So in the meantime, I'm gonna make some rice, get ready for, you know,
the taste.
Hey Google, stop. So that's been 30 minutes. Oh my goodness, it looks so good. It smells so good, but we're not quite finished yet. We're gonna thicken up the sauce. I've got 2 teaspoons of cornstarch here. I'm gonna add about a tablespoon of water. It has to be cold water, remember. Cornstarch does not dissolve in warm water. I'm just gonna create this slurry and we're gonna add it to the sauce. Try to move the meatball over a little bit so I can actually stir in the sauce. Let it thicken for a few minutes. I'm not finding that the sauce is thick enough, so I'm gonna add another 2 teaspoons of cornstarch, making another slurry. You know, guys, I'm trying this recipe out for the very first time, and my point is that if I can do it, you can do it. It's not hard. And I usually try to create recipes that are easy and simple for you guys to do at home.
Fun fact is that the vast majority of these videos are not from a test kitchen. They are done for the first time.
Okay, trying again. Okay, turning off the heat. You can see that the sauce has thickened a little bit. We're gonna add in our remaining green onions. Just let that cook for just a 30 seconds or so, and heat through. Right, look at that, guys. It's gonna be amazing. Are you all ready for?
This is gonna be good. I know I say that a lot, and I'm really not faking it because we haven't had this dish in forever. And we used to go to this restaurant, little hole in the wall close to home. And especially in the fall and the winter, you drive by, people are lined up outside, like peering into the glass. And when you get inside, tables are crammed together and all the windows are completely fogged up. But when the food comes out, it's delish. It's just so home style. And this is home style. This, including the white rice, which is not gonna make its appearance yet until dinner. It's a fabulous combination because look at all that luscious gravy. Yes! Duck egg and some napa cabbage, some siu choy. And this gravy is looking fantastic. Guys, this is so decadent. Duck egg yolk. It's one of my favorite things. Probably like super high cholesterol, but I love it. Usually when it's like in food, I'll eat the other food and leave the duck egg last.
To savor it.
Mm-hmm. The meat is velvety, tasty, a wonderful delivery vehicle for the yolk. So when you have that bowl of rice or that plate of rice, you just douse the rice with this luscious gravy and that meatball. Oh, the mouthfeel is fantastic. So many great textures and flavors. This is the one to do. Guys, you gotta do it. It's good.
All right, thanks, dude.
Yep.
Although I miss dining out, I am really excited about finding new and old recipes that I can make at home, and they're so simple to make. It just makes me wonder, like, why I ate out all the time for those dishes. We can just make them at home. For more recipes just like this, check it out, and I will see you over there.